Cases are up. Hospitalizations are also up. The governor is assuring the public that it's under control. But you think this is really going to strain the healthcare system in Arizona?
I do. When I talk to public health professionals and our doctors and nurses, they tell me they are deeply concerned. They are worried that our public thinks COVID-19 is something that we have defeated, while at the same time, 27% of all the cases we've had of COVID-19 in my county were in the last week.
Wow.
Transmission is up 40%, hospitalizations up 50%. We are going in the wrong direction.
Well, what's happening? Why do you think that's happening?
We were one of the last states to go to a stay-at-home order and one of the first to come out. I'm concerned that people are getting mixed messages about how serious this is. We see people who are out in our community grocery shopping, doing essential activities, but not in a mask. Really, the mixed messages have been difficult. I think some people thought, oh, it's flu goes away in the summer, so will the virus. We don't need to worry. Mm-hmm. We opened up against CDC guidelines with huge amount of services, including we went straight to nightclubs being open. So people were up close and personal dancing.
Wow.
We have elected officials who are not wearing masks and not modeling good behavior. And I think the mixed messages are confusing our residents.
Well, I mean, you were very blunt earlier today in saying what you said now. You said that quite simply that the state opened much too early. And that they're seeing the consequences of that. And there's a video of what you were talking about, the restaurants. We don't have the dance clubs where people are dancing around, but there you have it. You know, with parts of the economy already reopening, if the number of cases, if that number continues to climb, is it too late to walk that back, shut these things down again?
For our economy to really recover, people both have to feel safe and be safe. I talk to so many people who aren't sure what to do, and they're very cautious. That includes a lot of our older residents and includes people who have considerable spending power but aren't using it. So to me, safety and economy go hand in hand. The cities and states that take this seriously will have better recoveries. But these mixed signals, our hospitals saying that they really are worried about life-saving equipment, people aren't sure what to do. Companies aren't ready to invest. It's really an uncertain time. And I think my duty as mayor is to speak honestly with the people I represent and tell them what public health professionals are telling me. We are still actively fighting COVID. It is increasing in numbers of cases, and our percentage of tests that are positive are also increasing.
Wow. You know, Mayor, we saw large gatherings just 2 weeks ago for Memorial Weekend, Memorial Day. We've seen protests across this country every day since then. Do you think other cities and states are going to begin seeing these surges like you are?
I'm concerned that we didn't follow CDC guidelines and we just went to reopening a huge number of things right of way. So, for example, I spoke about the nightclubs. The Centers for Disease Control said start with restaurants, then go to bars, but with some spacing. We went straight to everything. As long as you served some sort of food, including a food truck, you were considered a restaurant and could open. And I think that sent a signal, we're home free. We don't need to worry about social distancing. I understand people are eager to go back to normal, but my message is that we still have to fight this virus. Masks are gonna be part of our life for a long time. We don't have a vaccine yet. But we do know that these interventions can save lives. When we went to stay at home, we slowed the spread. You can see the curve decline and the virus spread more slowly. We contained it, and now public health officials are saying we've undone the important work we did in April.
Mayor Kate, thank you for coming on and getting the word out and fighting for the citizens of your city. We appreciate it. Thank you, and be safe. Be safe.